good to have you with us. You're watching the Best of One Championship. Next up for you, Honorio Banario against Koji Oishi. When Honorio Banario lost his one championship featherweight title to Koji Oishi, it was undoubtedly the battle of the year. So their rematch was hotly anticipated. It took place in December of 2013 at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila.
12 years between these two. Banario surely has an advantage there. He's certainly got the advantage in height, albeit just 6 centimeters. This is for the title, the Philippines against Japan.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And this fight is 5 rounds for the ONE FC Featherweight World Championship. This fight is presented to you by Colt 45. Our 3 judges scoring this fight at cage side are Joey Lipitan from the Philippines, Josh Robinson from Singapore, and Rosenberg Rossette from the Philippines. Philippines, let's witness a battle! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, the challenger. This man is a striker, standing at 177 centimeters tall, weighing in at 65.8 kilograms, holding a professional record of 8 wins and 2 losses. Fighting out of Team Lakay, he is the former ONE FC champion from the Philippines, Honorio The Rock Banario! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler, standing at 171 centimeters tall, weighing in at 65.8 kilograms, with a professional record of 24 wins, 9 losses, and 10 draws. Fighting out of pancreasism, hybrid fighter from Japan, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning and defending ONE FC Featherweight World Champion, Koji Oishi! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Yuji Shimada.
It's a title shot, 5 minutes, 5 rounds, okay? No headbutt, things, no groin attacks, do not attack the back, okay? No non-stop the face. Clean fight, anytime, obey my command, touch gloves. Kona.
Champion against former champion. There's our Colt 45 ring girl.
Kona, Oish, Kona.
Mayati.
Judge. You ready?
Banario.
Go!
Against Oishi. The champion in blue, the challenger in red. Watch out for the big bomb.
The one thing that Banario said that he learned from that Oishi fight is to pace myself. I gotta slow down a little bit and pick my shots. So that's one thing that I think we see in the first opening half minute here. He's a little more methodical than he's usually been in his last few fights. And Oishi's really good with that springy moving in and out of range for those punches. You know, I have to wonder if a guy like Honorio Banario comes into this fight tonight, having been the champ, having seen the footage of your last fight with Oishi, seeing your teammates go 3-0 tonight, and being in front of your Filipino home crowd, if you feel pressure or if that pumps you up. You know, I think that tells a lot about a guy when he goes in there, how they respond to that. Do they thrive under the lights? Do they fold?
Well, it took 1 minute and 10 seconds for a punch to be landed. That feeling each other out process has certainly happened. Well,
25 minutes of make a wrong decision once is a real short night for one of these two.
That's a great point. In stark contrast to the explosive action we saw in their first fight. It'll warm up, never fear.
And like we talked about, Oishi has over 43 MMA fights under his belt. Not much you can throw at him he hasn't seen. Experience gonna definitely be a factor when this gets into those later rounds.
Oishi is the one that has more movement, more lateral movement. Banario stalking. Both men looking very composed. Concentration on Honorio's face. With his chin tucked in, looking straight ahead. Don't think he's blinked yet.
Well, sometimes you just see that there's a feeling out period, and a lot of times that's that first round. Kind of get acclimated to the space, find your distance a little bit. Nice head kick.
And the first big punch, really, of the fight thrown from Banario didn't land, but it was...
First big punch was the kick. I don't think Oishi's head discriminates.
Action!
Oh, now there's a good left and right. Quick 1-2 to the top of Oishi's head. Oh, good right hand from Oishi.
Yeah, Oishi blocked most of those punches that Banario came back with. Both guys showing a lot of respect for the other one. I mean, you have to, right? Because they both got knocked out.
Exactly, yeah. There's got to be some caution.
Entering more of a methodical approach.
Entering into the final 90 seconds of this round. Complete contrast to that first round in their first fight.
Oh, a nice side kick.
Action!
Right on the money. Tough round to score so far. I don't really know who you can give this one to.
Well, that's the thing. You don't really have to come down on either side. This, the end of the round doesn't signal a point where you need to judge. It's just pretty even at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm just thinking as far as... I don't look at it as five short races. I look at it as one long race. But, like, at this point, which car is ahead?
Yeah.
Good combinations. See, Banario lets his hands go. He can really put Oishi in some trouble, but Oishi just hasn't really wanted to use that wrestling that he's shown he's kind of relied on in the past.
It wasn't just lip service, was it, when Honorio said that he was going to be more patient? He's really looking focused. And as we enter the final 10 seconds of the round, neither men will come out of this with any big advantage. They acknowledge each other with a tap of the gloves.
Well, Banario, I think, has been slightly more aggressive in this round. Not much damage done by either, but I think that both men know that, hey, look, this is a title fight. I have the belt now. You had the belt then. You knocked me out. I knocked you out. Craziness has happened, so I think they're just taking their time to feel it out in the first round here. May not be the worst strategy.
Pitik, mayat din pitik mo ah. Mayat din napapasma sa isa rin.
Ato ay kanayon tangay, mamunulog lang.
Oo. Hanggang ka man din ano-ano, basta ano kang no chance, asikan ka makasya siya.
Pero ay enough to na.
Ilang baka man change strategy kasi na bawantayam, ano kam di, usaram din, ano kam din edge mo. Ano kam din distance mo, mabawantayam.
Fire yourself, you must go
five. Our Colt 45 ring girl, Christine Hallower, signaling the start of the second round. Featherweight championship belt for one fighting championship on the line. There's the challenger. And former champion.
Fight!
Honorio Banario. Against Koji Oishi in the blue trunks.
Well, this will be interesting to see if either Banario. It looks like Bonario's gonna get back in that rhythm a little bit. He looks a little more wiry and springy this round. Oishi's got the same pace that he always has. I see more urgency out of Banario from this round. Oh, and a nice takedown defense. Banario has really worked on his takedown defense. The whole Team Lakay camp has. Some of the losses they suffered at the hands of just better wrestlers. It's a constantly evolving process in MMA. Oishi's not really getting inside on Banario. It looks like he's a little bit more reluctant to engage.
He really isn't throwing so much at all, Oishi, is he? It's Banario that's leading the way, not at any great pace, it must be said, but Oishi's game seems to be a countering game at the moment.
Yeah, but you know, Oishi keeps moving left and he's circling into Benario's right hand. And also his right power leg, he's gotta be careful.
And listen to the crowd.
Big fight, big expectations.
Break, boss. More action.
Yeah, Yuji Shimada says more action, and the crowd like that. I think Yuji heard the crowd.
Yeah, I think the crowd's now rooting for Yuji.
We're always rooting for Yuji. Everyone.
Well, you know, if they have to give a yellow card at some point, I'm thinking they're going to give it to Oishi because he's the one backing up and disengaging.
Yeah.
And if nothing else at the end of this fight, you look at, well, there's not that much damage, and there were no submission attempts, no takedown attempts. All right, he moved forward. He wanted to engage.
Who was forcing the pace?
Exactly.
Honorio, more attack.
Well, that's certainly Banario. Now the crowd are really getting into it. Trying to make their own noise, force these fighters to get a little bit more involved. It's a lesson that was learned the hard way for Banario, to be more patient, to be a little more circumspect.
Action.
He's putting that into action tonight. If you rush into this man from Japan, you will get punished, as the Filipino knows only too well, at the expense of his belt. Oh. Good knee work.
Well, Banario is definitely throwing heavy punches. He's looking for the knockout when he's inside there. So Oishi's just been outside of range. And that was a little more of a pawing left hook by Oishi.
Action!
Yuji Shimada shouts out, action.
You know, oftentimes it takes two fighters to make a good fight. And there we go.
For the first time, really, Oishi initiated a move and he got punished for it.
Well, this is, you know, a big fight for Oishi because he came into 1FC on his debut, like you heard him talk about. And he really snuck out the back door with the belt, you know, and this is, this may be.
Oh, but he caught Honorio there. And it rocked him.
Yeah, and he got in on a single leg. Gotta be careful here, Honorio still
He's
rocks.
In trouble. Oh. Where have we seen this before? He's got some power, the Japanese man. He throws those short punches viciously. They're very, very crisp.
You know, I'm a little surprised that Oishi gave Banario so much time to kind of recompose when he stood up. It seemed like he had him hurt there for a little bit and didn't really stay on him for as long as I think he could have, but I can't really tell from the, we'll get a look at that replay maybe during the break.
Oh, great right hand, and Bonario's hurt again, and again he recovers. He manages to get back onto his feet and he's punching back.
Let's go, let's go!
But those punches hurt, and that's twice in this round he's been rocked.
Well, it only takes one to find its way through to the target. And it's good night. There's a couple of nice punches back from Banario. Well, this round has picked up the action. If we see more of this going into 3, 4, and 5, I think the fans are gonna be pleased.
Honorio Banario will welcome the minute's rest. Twice he was shaken, and quite badly shaken in that round.
Yeah, Oishi said special delivery. Just missed the trip there. Banario was able to counter with a couple of nice strikes, but it was really that one right left that wobbled Bonario's legs a little bit there, and he came in for that single leg. Just kind of regaining his composure, and right there you saw that Oishi. And if Oishi would have tagged him with that second shot, I think it would have been lights out for Banario, but he missed by a couple of inches and was able to let Banario kind of regain his whereabouts. You can see even here, Banario is still not really fully in it.
Seconds out. And I think you're right, Jason. The first time Honorio was rocked, I think Oishi could have done slightly more to follow up. But he certainly pinged him a second time. Now, what is Bonario's response?
About to find out here.
He certainly lost the edge that he had in this fight in terms of the lead. You'd now presumably would have Oishi ahead.
For sure. And that's a good way, I think, to look at MMA and 1FC is you don't look at it as a bunch of little sprints. You look at it as a long marathon, and this guy now has pulled ahead. Oishi's got to feel very confident with his hands now. He's found that mark with Banario twice. It looks like he's been setting up that left jab, right uppercut. See how he's kind of crunching over there. He's either trying to throw a right hand to the body or an uppercut up the center.
Good right hand. It was a left and a right hand. It was the right that was the better punch from Banario.
Bonario's looking a little more gun-shy now. He was moving forward the first two rounds. This is the first time we're seeing Bonario moving back.
He really got his bell rung twice in that second round. Understandably more cautious.
Oh, Yuji Shimada.
Oh, good punches from the Filipino, left and a right.
Like I said, I don't see this fight going all five rounds. It's going to be one of those wars. Someone's just going to feel that opening and throw caution to the wind.
So absorbing to watch because you just feel that at any second, there could be an explosion. Oh, good right hand, and Banario is out. It's over. Does this man have some power in his fists?
Two fights, two knockouts. Could Oishi ask for a better, more definitive stop to this fight? I do not think so.
Well, they asked for a rematch. They got a rematch, but surely there can be no doubt now. Two wins out of two for Koji Oishi. He retains his belt again in spectacular style. He rocked Bonario's world twice in the second round. And there was an earthquake in the third.
It was just a beautifully timed right hand that was right on the chin. And then that second shot really put Bonario down. You know, he rocked Bonario earlier with that right hand, but he wasn't able to follow up to get the rest of that. And you see Matt Hume in the background signaling that that's a very clean knockout. Yuji Shimada in and on top of the action as always.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimada calls a halt to this bout at a minute 43 seconds of round number three for your winner and still 1FC Featherweight World Champion, Koji Oishi!
And it's great that everyone here in the Mall of Asia Arena in the Philippines, having seen their man lose.
This has been the Best of One Championship. If you like what you've seen, make sure you hit the big red subscribe button below. We'll see you next time.